Knowing the tempo and time for each song lets your band focus on making great music instead of worrying about staying in the groove. We've rewritten the metronome to make it ultra accurate and added support for subdivisions while we're at it. We're not going to cover all the features of the metronome in this tutorial, so if you want more details, please watch the metronome video tutorial. Let's get started. Here's a song that doesn't have a tempo set yet. We can tap and hold on the metronome button in the live bar to open the tempo menu. Here we can swipe left and right to get close to the tempo we want, and then tap on the left or right side to adjust to an exact BPM. Once we have a tempo, tap on the play button to start playing it. In the upper left corner, you'll see 4/4. This is the time signature. We can tap and change the time signature, and the metronome changes accordingly. We can also change tempo on the fly. In the upper right corner, we see a new icon that looks like a quarter note. If we tap that once, it switches to an eighth note, and our metronome ticks twice as fast as it plays eighth note subdivisions. We can then tap again and get an icon that looks like an eighth note, but with a number 3 next to it. This places OnSong into an eighth note shuffle or swing rhythm. This swings the placement of the eighth note to provide a shuffle-like feel. Tap again, and we can have 16th note subdivisions. Now OnSong can handle some pretty crazy tempos at this clip. Let's max out the metronome to 200 BPM. And OnSong keeps ticking. If we switch the time signature to 6/8 time, we'll notice that the beat becomes almost impossibly fast, but still in time. This is because 6/8, 9/8, and 12/8 time signatures are compound, and that means they play tuples for each beat. We'll see how to set higher tempos if needed in our settings screen a little later. Let's tap on the 16th note again, and we're displayed a whole note. Now OnSong plays just the downbeat. Tap again for a half note subdivision. And then tap again for the standard quarter note. These subdivision settings get saved with your song, so it plays as you'd expect each time. You can also set up the subdivision in the song editor by using the beat or subdivision tag. Here are some values that you could set for different subdivisions. Now let's tap on the wrench icon to view metronome settings. We've separated this into audio and video tabs to make accessing the settings easier. In the audio tab, we can change the sound of the metronome and how it behaves. These settings are global, which means that any change here will apply everywhere in the app. If we scroll down, we'll see a minimum and maximum tempo setting. We could set these to accommodate tempos lower or higher than OnSong normally allows. This swing slider lets us adjust how the eighth note is offset when the swing shuffle subdivision is selected, so you can change the feel of the swing or shuffle beat. I hope that shows you some of the improvements we've made to OnSong's metronome and how to use subdivisions and other advanced metronome settings. If you have any questions, please contact us at onsongapp.com/support. Thanks for watching.